This video shows how to use ServiceNow Zero Trust Access to dynamically control access privileges for user sessions in a ServiceNow instance. This gives security administrators better control over users' access. During the session login process, ServiceNow Adaptive Authentication uses multiple criteria to limit a user's access privileges. Adding Zero Trust Access expands your authentication capabilities by adding the user's location and authentication attributes from your identity provider to the input criteria. Zero Trust Access also adds the ability to reduce users' access to the instance by removing specific roles based on their authentication criteria, rather than simply granting or denying full access. To configure user access using Zero Trust Access, we're logged in with the admin role. Now, we'll elevate our role to security admin. We'll navigate to Zero Trust Access and select Session Access Role Configuration. Each configuration contains an access policy, along with an action to perform if the policy evaluates to true. We'll open this configuration, remove ITIL role outside trusted network. Here is our access policy. We then open the record and see our policy input trusted network and view our policy condition outside the trusted network. When we open the condition, we see that it's true if the trusted network input is false. Or we can say if the user's IP address is outside the range defined for our trusted network, the policy evaluates to true. If the policy is true, we can take one of two actions to limit the user's access. We can remove specific roles from the user, or we can limit the user to specific roles. If we choose Remove Roles, Zero Trust Access removes the roles in this list, in this case, the ITIL role. Zero Trust Access also removes all the child roles for the roles in the list. You can check the child roles by clicking here. If the user does not have the role to be removed, but does have a child role, Zero Trust Access removes the child role. If we choose Limit to Roles, Zero Trust Access limits the user to only the roles in the list. That is, Zero Trust Access takes away all the roles the user may have, along with all of their child roles, except for the roles in the list. Zero Trust Access does not add any roles that the user doesn't already have. For this configuration, we want to remove the ITIL role. To use Zero Trust Access, we also need to set a few system properties. To enable Zero Trust Access, we'll select Enable Session Access. We'll also enable logging to help debug Zero Trust Access issues. The preference property determines whether the remove or limit action takes precedence. If a particular role appears in both a remove action and a limit action, to be taken at the same time, this property determines which action Zero Trust Access will take. Here, we'll remove the role. The audit data property determines how long the system retains session access data before deleting it. The information to be displayed property specifies the message users see whenever Zero Trust Access removes any of their roles. When a user logs in, they'll see this message, along with the session ID. This message also appears in the user's profile, so they can always find the session ID anytime after they log in. As a security admin, you can click Session Access Audit to view additional information. Here we can check the session access data and look up the session ID to find the Zero Trust Access policies that were applied for the session. We can also view the remove or limit actions that were taken and other information. That completes the setup. By reducing users' roles when they log in, under conditions you define, Zero Trust Access gives you better control of their access to your instance. For more information, see our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.